Advanced Emergency Medical Technician, Wikipedia Article Audio. Advanced Emergency Medical Technician is a mid-level provider of pre-hospital emergency medical services in the United States. A transition to this level of training from the Emergency Medical Technician Intermediate, which had somewhat less training, began in 2013 and has been implemented by most states at this point. The AEMT is not intended to deliver definitive medical care in most cases, but rather to augment pre-hospital critical care and provide rapid on-scene treatment. AEMTs are most usually employed in ambulance services, working in conjunction with EMTs and paramedics, however are also commonly found in fire departments as non-transporting first responders. The AEMT is authorized to provide limited advanced life support, which is beyond the scope of an EMT. Advanced EMTs must be certified as EMTs prior to seeking certification as an AEMT in most states. However, in some states AEMT is the introductory level and may not require prerequisites. Certification as an AEMT involves a class lasting from 3 to 6 months, the curriculum for which is largely outlined by the NEMT but can vary slightly from state to state. AEMT training is regulated at both the state and federal level. At the federal level, the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration has developed a minimum content and hour curriculum, known as the National Standard Curriculum, but this is not binding on the states. Along with classroom time, the AEMT student is required to complete several hours of clinical experience in an advanced life support ambulance or other ALS environment such as an emergency department. During these clinical hours, the AEMT student must successfully demonstrate full practical knowledge of skills learned. Upon completion of all classroom and practical skills hours, AEMT students must successfully pass a standardized psychometer and cognitive assessment before they can be certified. Education and training. EMTI/85. EMTI/85 is a level of EMTI training formulated by the National Registry of Emergency Medical Technicians in 1985. This training level includes more invasive procedures than are covered at the EMT basic level, including for therapy, the use of advanced airway devices, and provides for advanced assessment skills. The EMTI/85 typically administered the same medications as an EMTB, nitroglycerin, and metered dose inhalers such as albuterol. However, in some states they were also allowed to administer naloxone, D50, and glucagon. Like all other EMT levels, their scope of practice was governed by the state and/or their medical director. The EMTI/99 level was the closest level of certification to paramedic, and allowed many techniques not available to the EMTI/85 or EMT basic. These techniques included needle decompression of a tension pneumothorax, endotracheal intubation, nasogastric tube placement, use of cardiac event monitors/ECGs, and administering medication to control certain cardiac arrhythmias. The Advanced EMT or AEMT is the new mid-level EMS provider that has been introduced at the national level according to the new National EMS Scope of Practice Model. The AEMT replaced the EMTI/85 and EMTI/99, however some states have continued to teach similar levels, but they are not nationally recognized. The new scope consists of all EMT level skills, basic airway management and the insertion of supraglottic airways, suctioning of an already intubated patient, usage of a CPAP device, initiation of peripheral intravenous therapy, pediatric and adult intraosseous placement and several pharmacological interventions beyond the EMT level. These pharmacological interventions include administering. Other states may use different names for the above and often have a scope of practice beyond the minimal national standards. The EMTI/99 had a total of 3 recertification cycles to meet the requirements to transition to the paramedic level, while the EMTI/85 had 2 recertification cycles to transition to the AEMT. In addition to the standards established by the United States Department of Transportation, some states issue licenses for more specialized levels of training. The minimal psychomotor scope of practice at the national level for an AEMT includes EMTI/99. Alaska has an EMT-2, which is very similar to the I/85 standard, and the EMT-3, which is closer to the I/99 standard. A sponsoring physician can broaden the scope of an EMT-3 beyond state-defined protocols by providing additional training and quality control measures. This means that additional drugs and procedures can be accomplished by an appropriately trained EMT-3. The EMT-3 program is a short upgrade program, and does not generally receive reciprocity with other states. California uses an EMT designation which is equivalent to the National EMT Basic, an Advanced EMT, which is the intermediate level or limited advanced life support, followed by paramedic, ALS level. Advanced EMT. Iowa EMT Basics can administer EpiPen per protocol, insert a combi tube, and set up and maintain an IV that is non-medicated as well as all other basic skills. EMT Intermediates can establish an IV in addition to the EMT basic skills. An Iowa paramedic is a NREMT Intermediate/99 and is not the highest level of care in Iowa. This allows them to insert ET tubes and perform needle decompression, manual defibrillation, and medication administration. The Iowa paramedic specialist is the NREMT paramedic. Iowa also has a critical care endorsement for paramedic specialists. Massachusetts recognizes the DOT levels of EMTB, AEMT, and EMTP. EMT intermediates in Massachusetts followed the same protocols as the EMT basic, but were allowed to start IVs, perform fluid resuscitation, perform an ALS assessment, and insert advanced airways such as endotracheal tubes, combi tubes, and laryngeal mask airways. The intermediate level in Massachusetts has been phased out and replaced by the EMT advanced. However, most of the scope of practice remained the same. Maine recognizes 3 levels, EMT Basic, EMT Advanced, and EMT Paramedic. EMT Advanced in the state of Maine can provide many different treatments including 4 therapy, EKG monitoring, 12 lead EKG placement, dextrose, glucagon, and other medications. Advanced EMTs can also place laryngeal mask airway devices and use CPAP when needed. Some treatments and medications require consultation with online medical direction. Scope of practice. Michigan uses the National Registry AEMT examination, but does not require continued national registration when an AEMT renews. New York State has an AEMTCC certification, which is unique to New York, and is more advanced than a nationally recognized AEMT. In addition to the national scope of practice, New York also authorizes its AEMTCCS to intubate patients and do 3 lead ECG monitoring as well as 12 lead in certain counties, in addition to providing certain cardiac medications and cardiac care, including cardioversion. In more recent years, New York has expanded its AEMTCC level to include the administration of certain narcotics and some additional skills. In order to transition to the national standard, NICE has introduced an additional AEMT certification that meets national standard as of 2013. It still must be recognized by its regional EMS councils in order for those regions to begin implementing its use. However, progress has been steady, with the most recent county to accept the new level of certification being Nassau County. Nassau recognized this level in mid-2017. In 2018, NICE will begin a 10-year phase-out of its unique AEMTCC level of certification. However, one should note that no advanced EMT certifications are recognized in New York City except at volunteer agencies such as Hatsala EMS and Central Park Ambulance. One either functions as an EMTB or a paramedic within FDNY and affiliated services. Oklahoma recognized an EMT cardiac level until recently. However, that level has been phased out and providers in Oklahoma at the EMT cardiac level have since been trained and certified to the paramedic level or downgraded to EMTI. Pennsylvania uses the National Registry AEMT examination, but does not require continued national registration when an AEMT renews. However, the PAB Bureau of EMS has not defined a scope of practice and protocols as of September 2014. PA is new to this level of certification. As September 19, 2014, there are 6 PA-certified AEMTs in the Commonwealth. Rhode Island's first level ALS provider is EMT Cardiac, which is unique to Rhode Island and Virginia. The EMTC is a certification between the EMTI and EMTP, allowing the use of more cardiac drugs than the EMTI, but fewer than the EMTP. The time and cost of an EMTC program is generally less than one-third that of an EMTP program. EMTC or higher licensure may be required by Rhode Island fire departments, who provide emergency medical services in the majority of the state. Tennessee EMTs are licensed at either the EMT4 level or the EMT paramedic level. EMTIVs are trained to the NREMTB standard in accordance with DOT regulations, as well as receive additional training in advanced airway management, administration of epinephrine 1:1000 in anaphylaxis, administration of nebulized and aerosolized beta-2 agonists such as Copinex and albuterol, administration of D50W and D25W, for therapy and access, and trauma life support including the use of masked trousers. EMTIVs can also administer nitroglycerin and aspirin in the event of cardiac emergencies, and can give glucagon. EMTIVs can also administer the Mark I auto-injector kit for organophosphate poisoning and suspected nerve gas exposure. The State of Tennessee Board of EMS is currently evaluating allowing EMTIVs to administer naloxone and nitrous oxide as well. The board has accepted the new levels of EMR, EMT, EMT Advanced, and Paramedic. Gap analysis has been completed by the state and the board has moved to allow up to 4 years for the EMT4 to transition to EMT Advanced by way of an 8-hour course, choosing to let all EMT4s and paramedics under the current standard be renewed as usual for this cycle. In Virginia, the first level of ALS is EMT Enhanced, which is unique to Virginia. It is essentially equivalent to the EMTI/85. The EMT enhanced can start four lines, perform dual lumen airway insertion, and administer some medications such as D50W, glucagon, albuterol, epinephrine, and sometimes narcotics. They cannot, however, administer any cardiac medications. The next level of ALS is EMT intermediate, which is equivalent to the I/99 level of certification. In most counties, the EMTI operates under the same protocols as the EMT paramedic. There are a few procedures that only paramedics can perform, including rapid sequence intubation, surgical cricothyrotomy, and needle cricothyrotomy. Virginia phased out its cardiac tech level and replaced it with its intermediate level. In the state of Washington, EMT basic protocols are similar to those in Iowa. Certified EMTB personnel can administer EpiPen per state protocols and can insert a combi tube. The Washington EMTB can set up and maintain an IV that is non-medicated, but EMTI certification is required to start the IV. WA Office of Emergency Medical and Trauma System. Some county protocols accept an EMT/ILS tech which, in addition to all EMTI and EMTB skills, can administer D50W, naloxone, albuterol, and can now draw up epinephrine in addition to using the EpiPen. Wisconsin offers an EMT 4 technician certification for the EMT basic, allowing them to start basic 4 lines, treat for hypovolemic shock, and administer naloxone, D50W, and a limited number of other medications. This level of training is often used in non-urban areas where hospitals may be sparse and advanced life support intercepts or aeromedical transports can take a great deal of time. Additionally, some private ambulance companies employ EMT4 technicians for interfacility transports which only require 4 therapy and do not necessitate the specialized advanced care of a paramedic. Non-medicated intravenous fluids, sublingual nitroglycerin, epinephrine 1:1,000 for anaphylaxis, dextrose 50%, dextrose 25%, and glucagon for diabetics, naloxone for opioid overdoses, nitrous oxide for pain management, inhaled beta agonist medications for respiratory emergencies caused by asthma, COPD, etc.